guys, today we are going to discuss about a topic which is called as a friction. Clear? So let's start by the means of a definition. Friction is the opposing force. Friction is the opposing force that is set up between the surface of the contact. That is set up between the surface of the contact. Clear? When one body is slide, rolls or tend to do so on the surface of the another body, means अगर एक body है दूसरी body यहाँ पे रखती है, यहाँ point of contact के ऊपर एक force या opposing force need होगा जिसको हम बोलते हैं friction. उसी के लिए explain करने के लिए हम highlighted a one basic diagram table and the body A. Clear? Force of friction is on the opposite direction if applied force is along this direction. Clear? Before discussing the type of friction, then advantage of the friction and disadvantage of friction, let's discuss the term why the friction has been introduced or what are the facts by which we have introduced the term friction. Clear? Basically, there are the two basic factors. One factor is a body is here and you are applying a force less than the limit of the frictional force, the body is not going to be moved. Why? Second, as you apply the force greater than the limit of the friction, so what happened at the time? Body start moving. And after that it come into kinetic energy and after few distance it come to zero. Why that happen? So these are the two basic facts that leads the definitions of the concept of the friction. Clear? Which is opposing force that is set up between the surface of the contact when one body slide, rolls, tend to do so on the surface of the another body. Clear? We have classified the friction into four categories: static, sliding, rolling and fluid. Clear? Come to the what is the definition of the static friction? The force of friction that come into play when the surface of the two bodies before the body actually start moving, it is called as a static friction. Clear? And range varying from the zero to maximum value. Clear? And in the kinetic friction, the force of friction acting between two surfaces when one surface is in steady motion over the surface is called kinetic friction. Clear? So what it means when the body is not moving, before moving the body, what kind of the force is occurring there? That is static force. To explain that thing, we need to understand the concept of the self-adjusting nature of the friction. So what it means? Assume this is the second body and this second body having a resistance power of 10 Newton and we are applying a force of 1 Newton, 2 Newton, 3 Newton, 4 Newton, assume 5 Newton. Is that body is start moving? No. Reason? Resistance of this body is the 10 Newton. Body is not going to move. So what did it mean? Body is getting moving back to the reverse direction with the 5 Newton. Is it possible? No. It has happened? No. Have you seen? No. If you are going to apply 7 Newton, is it moving? No. Still, 3 Newton is remaining. Is it turning back? No. So that means that force having ability to self-adjust. If you are going to apply a force 1 Newton, it becomes 1. If you are going to apply 5 Newton, it becomes 5 Newton. If you are applying 9 Newton, it becomes 9 Newton. Unless you will apply 11 Newton or 12 Newton, then the body is going to move from that surface. At that time, whatever the friction has occurred, that is called as a static friction. Clear? and the when the body is in a motion, when the body comes in a steady motion, at that time friction is occurred, that is called as a kinetic friction. Clear? In rolling friction generally occur when there will be any body is rolling over the another surface, like a wheel, tire, example car, bike, cycle, train, and then one surface is rolling on the another surface. Clear? In fluid friction, that generally occur between liquid and the gases. We are not going to discuss the rolling and the fluid friction in detail here. Clear? For that I will make it another video to complete discussion regarding the rolling and the friction. Clear? So I am not going to highlight the more about that things. So these are the basic four frictions which I have highlighted. Clear? Now I need to discuss about the cause. What are the basic cause, reason behind the friction? What actually happened at the time? The body is here. So what is actually happening at the time? So we basically categorize or consider two basic cases. That cases is the one is called as a interlocking. Second is called as a atomic or molecular bonding. Clear? What is the interlocking? If you see, this is a whiteboard. If you see with naked eye, it appears as very smooth. But when you try to see with the help of scanning electron microscopy, transmission electron microscopy, that whiteboard is not as smooth. It is still a rough. Clear? So when a one body is going to get in contact with another, so they get interlocking. What the mean of interlocking? Let's revise it. As I am saying, if you seeing this whiteboard as a smooth, but when we are going to analyze this whiteboard with the help of a scanning electron microscope or transmission electron microscope, you will able to find this whiteboard is not a smooth, it is rough. If it is rough, so it create a projection and depressions. What are that? For to explain that things, I have drawn some basic diagram. Body 1, body 2, B body, A body. If you see, I have drawn like this, in which upper height is called as a projection and lower is called as a dispersion. Same for the body A. Clear? So what happened? Upper, lower. So what happened? Depression of the second get contact with the projection of the first, so they get interlocked with each other. So what happened now? If you required a minimum force to slide this object from here to here, so that is a one kind of the assumption for the basic cause of the friction in a sliding. Similarly. When two body get in a contact with each other, we assume there will be a atomic or molecular attraction or bonding between the two surfaces when they get contact with each other. Again, you required a minimum force to overcome that force of attraction. So these are the two basic reasons which we are basically considered or assumed for the sliding friction. Clear? So next we can discuss about the basic advantage and disadvantage of the friction and the basic examples related to the frictions. Firstly, we will talk about the basic examples. In static, any body which you are seeing at a rest position or a zero position, that is example of a static friction. Table, chair, duster, that is in a static friction, work in a static friction. Live example of the sliding friction, when you are going to rub your hand, when you are going to rubbing your hand, and when you are going to rub the whiteboard, that is an basic example of the sliding friction. when you're driving a car, riding the bike, at that time it is a best example of the rolling friction. For skydiving, it is an example of the fluid friction. So these are the basic example of the frictions, different types of the friction. Advantage and disadvantage. I will give you the one basic example, which is the both acts as advantage and disadvantage. That is our human being. If we are moving, that is only happen with the help of the presence of a friction. If we eliminate the friction from our daily life, that means we are not able to walk properly. Take an example of a common first or a very smooth first or a ice. So in ice there is a very less friction is there, and it is very difficult to drive a car and very difficult to move on the ice or to make a grip. So friction is most important for us as a part of life. Clear? And in last, hope whatever I have delivered you, you have understand the things in a proper way. Clear? If you want to recall the things, you can replay it. Clear? Next, if you want to download the basic notes related to that or any other topic, I will provide you the basic link in a description box. Hit on that link, you will be able to download. Clear? And the last, I will again give you the one new definition of the friction in a simple way. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.